he failed out of PA school. He failed out of PA school. I'm going to call him Tom. Tom was a student at the one program I was teaching at in Western New York. And Tom was a little bit older of a student, and he was a little slower than some of the students, but boy, did he work hard, and he wanted it badly. I was working as a hospitalist at the time, and he actually took one of his nights off and just came to shadow me because he wanted to learn more about clinical medicine. Problem is, Tom had some substandard grades, so he got decelerated. He got decelerated a year, and I can't imagine how heartbreaking that is. But that was the policy. You know, if you don't keep your grades up, you get decelerated. So he came back the next year, same degree of passion, enthusiasm, worked his butt off, but he also had substandard grades again. And I'll never forget going into the faculty meeting where they say, hey, Tom's failing his class. We got to kick him out of the program. And I remember saying, don't do it. He's going to be fine. Oh, he's not making the grades. That's our policy, they said. Well, if it's the policy, then why are we having this meeting? Okay, why are we even discussing it if it's the policy and that's the rigid structure that you're going to practice running a PA school? You're not going to look at compassion. You're not going to look at emotional intelligence. You're not going to look at someone's ability to grow. Okay, there's a book called Mindset that talks about a fixed mindset versus a growth mindset. This guy had a growth mindset. And they said, we're going to kick him out. So they had a vote. I didn't agree, so I voted no, don't kick him out. Well, they kicked him out. They kicked him out of the PA school. But I believed in the guy. Tom reached back out to me and said, John, I want to apply to another PA school. Can you give me a reference? Of course I could. So I gave him a reference. He got another PA school. He did fantastic. He thrived. He passed his boards the first time. And he spent the majority of his year working down south in cardiology and urology. And I still see him every once in a while at conferences. He warms my heart. That's tenacity. That is tenacity. That's someone who motivates me. I goosebumps telling the story. Okay. He never quit. PA school is super hard. And one of the things I found, I get to go around the country and teach at a bunch of PA schools. There are different cultures. There's different cultures of PA schools. Some of them are very tight, very rigid. Some schools, guys, they make you wear ties when you go to class. Other ones are much more lax and much more family friendly. Like when I went to King's College, I was very afraid of failing. Very afraid. And the program director, Dr. Babonis, I said, you know, what do I have to do to fail? Like I kind of mentioned something like I'm nervous about the grades. And she said, John, as long as you don't quit, you'll be fine. I'm like, I'll never quit. I will go through a brick wall. And I wish I could say that about every PA school, because if you don't make the grades, you jeopardize their national average on the physician assistant national certification exam. So programs have become very, very tight. Allow me to help you. My name is John Blinsky. I'm a PA educator. This is what I do. YouTube my name. Look at testimonials from my live conferences. Look at some of the ways I teach. See, I struggled because I got dyslexia, right? I don't learn like traditional people learn. So I see things in images and colors. I see things in mnemonics. It's a God-given gift that's not of my doing. You know, I've worked for 22 years, but for about 15, 16 of those years, I've run emergency rooms, which means I worked by myself taking care of very, very, very sick people. And now I get the privilege of teaching people how to take care of very sick people in a way that makes it really easy to approach. So in about 2 weeks, I'm going to be coming out with a program called the Pre-PA Kickstart. Let me kickstart your studies. Let me prime you in a way that optimizes you going into your didactic phase. There are some programs in PA education that are easy. They're easy. Some of them are wicked hard, and that's why Tom failed out. It was clinical medicine and pharmacology. Let me teach you clinical medicine so your knowledge is kickstarted before you walk in and you're like, yeah, I know the fundamentals of this disease. Let me help you with pharmacology, key understandings, big picture items. Let me tell you what you need to know, because part of the problem with PA education is a lot of times they teach you things that are a little bit silly, that don't really equate to getting a test question right, or sure doesn't equate to clinical care. Let me help sift through that. Allow me to be your pre-PA mentor. Allow that to be a title that I can help you with. I'd be honored and privileged. My name is John Blinsky. Good luck and God bless.